there's no such thing as a shabby Bentley. Despite the fact that the new for 2019 Bentayga V8 is $30,000 more affordable than its W12-controlled kin, the twin-turbo V8's $165,000 window sticker still puts it well into the more elite class of expensive extravagance vehicles. Bentley is reluctant to think about the two adaptations of the Bentayga, what parent needs to set kin against each other. Yet frames the V8 release as a to some degree sportier contrasting option to the pedal to the metal, marvelousness and charm W12. How about we look at that line of thinking? In the engine of the Bentayga V8 is a 4.0-liter turbocharged motor that offers the greater part of its bits with the most recent Porsche Panamera and Cayenne turbo. The motor is particularly tuned for use in this new application, with a one-of-a-kind sound mark and a cooling bundle that Bentley says will keep it running serenely even despite the biggest leaves and rises on the planet. The V8's pinnacle of 568 pound-feet of torque hits underneath 2,000 revolutions per minute and stays precisely there until the point when 4,500, with a pull pinnacle of 542 at 6,000. From in the driver's seat, the Bentayga's V8 motor feels somewhat higher hung than the easy W12. Rather than moment torque, there's a solid surge of energy that manufactures pleasantly until the point when it nears its 7,000 revolutions per minute redline, the most noteworthy rev breaking point of any motor the brand has ever introduced in a traveler vehicle. In the event that such a peaky sounding motor appears to be disjointed with the purpose of an extravagant SUV, simply realize that there's a lot of stock accessible whenever the driver chooses to push a red-bottomed Louboutin into the rich cover. It's only somewhat less than what it'd be accessible if the need arises from the W12, yet there's insufficient of a disparity to extremely matter. The V8 is somewhat less buoyant to 60 than the W12, 4.4 seconds versus 4.1. And, with its 180 mph top speed, it's a nameless 7 mph slower at the best end, as well. Along these lines, that doesn't generally bolster the possibility of energy. Neither too does the V8 handle any uniquely in contrast to the W12. There's just around 100 pounds isolating the two vehicles, with the new V8 version tipping the scales at 5,264 pounds. What's more, since just 50% of that weight investment funds is focused over the front pivot, there isn't any genuine change to the Bentayga's driving progression or controlling feel. This isn't to imply that the Bentley Bentayga V8 doesn't drive well, it simply doesn't drive uniquely in contrast to its all the more intense, more costly kin. One hand, that is something worth being thankful for, the W12's driving elements are magnificent, yet on the other, we'd love to disclose to you that the V8 adaptation felt lighter on its feet. Regardless, all the inalienable capacity of Bentley's cutting-edge electronic undercarriage control frameworks mean the V8 is similarly in the same class as the W12 when driving out and about, or off it. Or on the other hand on snow and ice, as should be obvious in the video beneath. Stick around after the ice driving show for a nearer takes a gander at the inside and outside highlights of the most recent Bentley SUV. Bentley's 48-volt electronic hostile-to-move framework is discretionary on the V8, it's standard on the W12, and it's a suggested expansion. Electric engines respond right away to suppress the leanings of the monstrous Bentayga with about 740 pounds to foot of moment torque. That much power is vital, considering the powers at play when 2.6 tons of SUV pitch and influence on 21 or 22-inch haggles. Indeed, even with the cutting edge against smooth bits, there's a lot of squat and jump under hard increasing speed and braking, however cornering loads are all around oversaw, even snappy side-to-side changes. Discretionary on both V8 and W12 Bentayga models for 2019 are the biggest carbon-fired brakes on the planet, clipped by 10-cylinder calipers at the front. Purchasers who need to stay with press brake plates can pick discretionary red calipers. Strangely, the carbon circles stay with harmless dim-painted calipers. Some may incline toward the look of the Bentayga V8 over the W12, since it shuns chrome for dim paint for the grille and gets an extraordinary combine of fumes outlets with a pleated focus to influence them to look from a separation like four particular funnels. A discretionary carbon fiber outside bundle adds a back spoiler to the top of the SUV, and keeping in mind that such an extra appears to be pointless, it really looks sort of cool. What's more, that most likely issue significantly more than any true wind current necessities. Just like the case outwardly, there aren't any real changes to the inside of the Bentayga in this new V8 pretense. polished carbon fiber trim is currently discretionary, joining Bentley's typical matte complete carbon and an entire host of wood facades sourced from everywhere throughout the world. As you'd anticipate from a Bentley, about each surface is strong and suede than smooth or knitted calfskin or extravagant feeling texture. There are several plastic bits that appear to be strange. Remarkably, the tube-formed air channel bulges on the focal point of the dash, yet since they aren't touch focuses, it likely doesn't much make a difference. We're enthusiasts of the Bentayga's infotainment framework, regardless of whether it is cribbed from the Audi Parts Index, which presents beautiful high-determination satellite symbolism rather than antiquated two-dimensional maps. The two front inhabitants have a lot of room, and the ergonomics are darn near great. For extreme plushness, spec the Bentayga with two back can situates rather than a seat and appreciate the colossal focus reassure and electrically worked controls. In any case, the lodge feels splendid and vaporous on account of an enormous clear rooftop board. Which Bentayga should purchasers pick? That is a strangely extreme inquiry. Actually, the V8 isn't as brisk or capable as the W12, doesn't generally deal with any in an unexpected way, and even the new 17.3-inch carbon brakes are shared over the line. Put basically, it's not a sportier alternative, in spite of what Bentley may assert. However, that doesn't mean it's not worth thought from the individuals who can manage the cost of a $200,000 extravagance utility vehicle. The market for super lavish game utility vehicles is bigger than you might suspect, and the Bentayga is effortlessly Bentley's top-of-the-line display. Maybe the nearest current opponent to the Bentayga is Land Rover's Range Rover SV autobiography, which begins at $177,200 and moves from that point. Like the Bentayga, the Rover gloats a well-worn identification with a storied family, a super extravagant inside, and true blue rough terrain capacities. Now that there's a lower estimated Bentayga, Bentley stands to pick up clients that may have generally considered a less extreme Audi, BMW, or Mercedes. There's so little distinction between the two motors offered in the Bentayga that a shrewd purchaser may choose to pick the V8 and put those residual $30,000, less, really, in the event that you pick the dynamic against move framework. However, the cost of that choice hasn't yet been uncovered, into some discretionary comforts or even some bespoke customization. In the event that one of the several discretionary inside and outside shading plans isn't to your loving, a speedy call to the Mulliner division will procure the purchaser a totally exceptional extravagance SUV. Furthermore, that might be more vital to style cognizant purchasers than the quantity of chambers underhood. Or then again, considering that $30,000 is appropriate close to the normal cost of another vehicle in the United States, a client could put that spared cash into a Miata, an exemplary roadster, or even the superbike. We're not by any stretch of the imagination beyond any doubt that the selection of motors has any important effect at all. There's no common sense motivation to pick the W12 over the V8, however of course there's no pragmatic motivation to purchase a Bentley Bentayga in any shape. You either need one or you don't, you can either bear the cost of one or you can't. Pick a powertrain, either powertrain, and you presumably won't be disillusioned. Indeed, you'll get precisely what you paid for, a Bentley identification and a top-of-the-line ticket to the front line at the valet part.